Well, ladies and gentlemen, senior staff of the JFK Hospital, I'm Rufus Nouvel. This is my team. I represent the People Action Network. They represent several other organizations under the umbrella of the RCOP. I need not go into what is going on with the world now in terms of our medical condition. We are confronted with a very deadly virus that they have named the coronavirus. We don't have much in Liberia to fight. We are getting complaints from the big countries around the world that they too have great challenges, and they are shutting down the most part of their economies. The JFK has been a partner to Liberia since its formation. In the wartime, it was the JFK. Peacetime, it's still the JFK. So we just thought to identify with the John F. Kennedy Medical Center with a small donation of 50,000 Liberian dollars to help you in the fight against corona. We know, like my team tried to explain to me, the amount is insignificant. It's very small. The problem with JFK, I mean, you have very enormous challenges that we cannot handle. But I'm a Christian, and we often say little is much when God is in it. So we are pleased to present a little amount of $50,000 on behalf of the RCOP family to help you get soap, get water, and, you know, enhance your capacity to fight the coronavirus. And just to conclude, we also want to use this occasion to call on all well-meaning Liberians. The JFK is always there for us. I remember the JFK during April 6th. I remember the JFK 1990 war. I remember the JFK World War I, World War III. This is the time JFK needs us. We've always been in need of JFK, but the table has turned. So the well-meaning Liberians out there, the rich people, the poor people, please make little contribution to JFK. And don't be ashamed of your contribution. Even a bucket will help the hospital. Even a box of Clorox will help the hospital. So on behalf again of the ICOP, I want to say we're very happy to be here, and you can count on us in whatever way we can. Thank you again for your hard work.
Thank you so much. My name is Dama Yekesenkova. I'm the acting CEO here at JFK, also the deputy CEO for administration. And we're very appreciative for you being here today. I think this is by far a pioneer effort to encourage Liberians to continue to contribute to the hospital. We have partners that have come in the past. We all know that right now, with the threat of the coronavirus, we're all being on the alert and being more careful as to how we interact with people in our contact and what have you. But we're here, like I've explained to my staff, to ensure that we continue with the mandate to continue to serve the Liberian people in good times and bad, in whatever situations we find ourselves in. I'm not as versed on the perils in the past because I haven't resided home for quite a few years. But for what I know, JFK has always been there, like you said, and I reiterate, in supporting Liberians through whatever times we're going through. So we continue to do that. We're doing it in a more safe environment by trying to reduce the number of people that we're serving at any one point in time. If you've been paying close attention to some of the advice being given, you're asked to practice some social distancing so that, you know, if someone is symptomatic and they're coughing or sneezing, you know, you're not as likely to contract whatever they have. So we're trying to practice that with our patients and encourage folks to try to practice that social distancing, washing your hands, you know, coughing in your sleeve and trying to just protect yourselves. I think this is the time that we all need to just be smart about how we care for ourselves and others around us. So again, we thank you. You keep saying this is an insignificant amount of money, but I tell you what, it is not. And the reason I say that is because no amount given from the heart is insignificant. And we appreciate the contribution. We're here to serve you all, the Liberian people. So please don't hesitate to come to us if you have to. If you have an emergency, please come to the hospital. If it's something that can wait for your own safety, we ask that you let, you know, we're not saying don't come to the hospital if you're not feeling well, if you're sick. Please don't misunderstand us. But if it's something that is not urgent, that you can wait while things kind of subside for your own safety so that you're not getting in public transportation or getting in congested areas if you don't have to be, then we're encouraging people to stay home at least until most of this threat blows over. But we're here to serve the people of Liberia and will continue to do so. We thank you so much for your contribution.
All right, this is the very little.
Thank you so much.
$50,000. And just one quick question. Do you have any units set up just in case somebody should, you know, come with corona or start coughing or something? Is there a room? Can you quarantine somebody at the JFK? That's a question a lot of people ask us.
Okay, so one of the things we're doing right now is putting in policy in order to understand our practice flow as it pertains to how we're doing and triaging and taking care of patients as they come to the hospital. If you observed, when you came through the hospital front gate, you had to wash your hands. Your temperature was taken. So we're trying to take those measures from the outside of the JFK into the hospital facilities. We've gone as far as putting out a patient flow as it pertains to someone being maybe seen as having some of the symptoms that may be associated with the coronavirus. You know that the flu and having a cold and having corona, they're very, very similar symptoms. So we have to be careful not to just assume that everyone has corona or, you know, are symptomatic just because they may have a cough or what have you. So we're taking a blanket of symptoms together, and based on the checklist, when you come as a patient, based on that checklist, we're able to determine if we need to take it a step further to call the 4455 number to have that dealt with at the state level. Here at JFK, we're not triaging patients or quarantining patients. The mandate right now is to refer them to the Ministry of Health for onward treatment. So that's what we're doing right now. So our primary goal is to try to triage patients and observe those who may be at risk or high risk for having the coronavirus and try to forward them on for treatment.
Okay? All right. Thank you very much.
You're most welcome.
Thank you for your time.
Thank you, too.
Thank you. Sorry, we can't shake hands.
No, absolutely, but...